world-class family. My grandfather was a coal miner in South Wales, hence the name Iestyn, hence the heritage from Wales. And in 1946, he moved across to Holland to play, to captain Holland Rugby League Cup, and to go on to court for the Rugby League Cup. My father was an amateur player in Holland, and he was fortunate enough to play 12 games for Holland as well. And as a youngster, growing up in Holland, going in and around the town, having a grandfather who played for the club, captained the club, coached the club, dad who played for the club, who supported the club, you can imagine what I wanted to do. My whole ambition, I had two ambitions in life, certainly in my short-term life, which was, one was to be a professional rugby player, and two, probably more importantly, was to represent all the following my father and grandfather's footsteps. And when I was 15, I got the opportunity to go and train a little as a schoolboy, and they gave me a six-week trial, and essentially said, at the end of the 6 weeks, we'll determine whether you're going to get a professional contract at all. When I went into the training ground at Watersheds, I gave absolutely everything in them 6 weeks. And it was there at this time, and in and around the next 2 or 3 years, that I really worked out what the 1% effort meant. And, you know, Jim talked about it a little bit in his challenge that he's had. You know, the 1% effort, and the best way I can describe it is DNA. DNA is an absolutely fascinating thing because 99% of our DNA is exactly the same. It's absolutely identical. It's the 1% that makes us who we are, it makes us unique. It's our eye colour, it's the skin colour, it's the facial features. And it's that 1% that makes you, you and me, me. Now, and when I was 15, I'd been at the training ground for around 6 weeks, and as I said, I'd thrown absolutely everything into it. And at the time, the head coach there was an Australian guy called Peter Tunks, giant Australian, about 6 foot 8, quite an imposing character, certainly for a 15-year-old boy. He knocked on the change room's door after the 6 weeks and said, could he have a word with me and could I come into his office? And I followed him up a small corridor and sat in his office and sat down in front of him, absolutely frightened to death, but thinking, this is it, you know, this is my starting my career. This is where I'm going to start a journey, I'm going to start playing for Oldham, I'm going to start playing with the league. I'll never forget his words. He sat down in front of me and he said, as a head coach of any club, but as a head coach of Oldham, it's my job to give good news and it's my job to give bad news. And unfortunately on this occasion, this is a bad news situation, he said, if I'm sat in your shoes, he said, I'm stood in your shoes, then I would really decide about a different future because you're not going to be a rugby league player. He said, and the reason you're not going to be a rugby league player is because, one, you're not big enough to be a forward, and two, you're not fast enough to be a back. And if I was sat there, I would determine, go and do something else, but you're just not going to do it. And as a 15-year-old boy, I remember walking out absolutely devastated. Testosterone flying through your body, and I was absolutely devastated. I got in my dad's car, I'd never even picked the kit up. Got in my dad's car, he took me home, never said a word in the car. Got home at night and thought, shit, where do I go from here? This is it, this is the end of my journey, what should I do? And I slept the night and woke up the next morning. I said, right, I've got three options. And option one is to give up and go and do something else, go and get a real career. I wasn't quite ready for that. And the second option was to get bigger, to go to the gym, pump some weights, build myself up. My hero growing up was a guy called Jonathan Davis, and I'm sure you all know him. And he's a pundit now, and he was a fly half for Wales. He was playing at the time for Widnes. Absolute genius of a guy, lightning quick, could turn a sixpence. And if I wanted to be the next Jonathan Davis or anything like achieving what Jonathan did, I couldn't get any bigger. So my third option was I had to get faster.